This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
The view from the cliffs, mesmerizing.
I've seen people stand here for hours.
In the middle of a storm, terrifying.
I've had windows blown out, doors blown in.
After a hike and a fresh brewed beer, satisfying.
So everybody that comes off the hiking trails is really thirsty.
Tonight, the many moods of Maine's Monhegan Island, a place where change is slow.
The main dining room still lit by lamp oil and candle, thank you.
Law enforcement is low key.
They've given me a badge, and it's in here somewhere.
And everybody is feeling the love.
Monhegan. Oh, I loved Monhegan.
The main streets and back roads of Monhegan Island, next on Chronicle. And good evening. Tonight we travel to a remote island, one that only recently bowed to modern life and brought in electricity.
Ted Reinstein says Monhegan is rugged, raw, and a place visitors love.
There are more than 4,600 islands off the coast of Maine, but in the hearts of many, not one comes anywhere close to Monhegan.
Even if they come one time, Monhegan. Oh, I loved Monhegan.
Monhegan sits about 10 miles offshore, a granite gumdrop in the Gulf of Maine, topped by balsam and spruce, sprinkled with wild lupin, 1 square mile of concentrated enchantment.
It's a spectacular island.
With its dramatic cliffs, among the highest on the Atlantic seaboard, Monhegan has proved irresistible to artists since the 1800s. It's an allure that has not diminished with time.
The only drawback to me about Monhegan is that it has too many other lovers other than me. They're like mushrooms around here every place I look.
Perhaps Monhegan's most notable resident, artist Jamie Wyeth, son of celebrated painter Andrew Wyeth, grandson of famed illustrator N.C. Wyeth.
As a very young child, I would look out from where my family lived, Cushing. You could just make out Monhegan in the distance. I mean, to me, to be far out at sea and away from everything was just my idea of the best.
Wyeth has painted everything from pigs to presidents, but he returns time and again to the rich simplicities of Monhegan, the drama of its landscape, the pragmatic poetry of its houses, and the dignity of those who live here, human or not. But Wyeth's close observation of nature often makes room for a puckish magic. In Moonlight Voyeur, his old friend Andy Warhol makes a spectral appearance on the rocks of Monhegan's Lobster Cove.
No, he never came to Monhegan. It's too bad because he came to my farm a lot. That was the city. He was a man of many contrasts.
Wyeth's home is a Monhegan icon, standing sentinel over Lobster Cove. Painter Rockwell Kent, one of Wyeth's idols, built the house for his mother.
When he built it in 1905, all the islanders said, it's going to be blown away in the first Southwester. And I've had windows blown out, doors blown in, but it's still here, knock on wood.
Wyeth splits his time between Maine and a farm in Chad's Ford, Pennsylvania. He also paints in a lighthouse he owns in nearby Tennant's Harbor on the mainland, but the house on Lobster Cove gives him an unobstructed front row seat to nature at its fiercest and most grand.
To be here in a storm is really unbelievable because the sea goes over top of the house and the whole house just shakes because it's built on this ledge, and I just love it.
Monhegan's dramatic cliffs, rising 160 feet straight up out of the Atlantic, unquestionably the island's high point.
Well, I've seen people stand here for hours and just watch the ocean. It's very calming.
In fact, 3/4 of Monhegan is protected land, the vision of one man, Ted Edison.
Ted Edison was the youngest child of Thomas Alva Edison. He came out here in 1908 as a 10-year-old with his mother.
Margot Sullivan is with the Monhegan Associates, the nonprofit that oversees the island's wildlands. She says Edison, a lifelong summer visitor, was alarmed at plans to develop the backside of the island piece by piece. He bought up parcels, forming one of the first land trusts in Maine.
I cannot imagine what this would be like if Ted had not done this. Where we're standing would have been a development. It was mapped out in streets and house lots all the way out here to Burnt Head, all the way to Whitehead. And when I look at that map, I cannot visualize houses coming all the way out here to this beautiful ocean. I cannot imagine it.
Today, few of the hikers on these cliffs know how close this rugged land came to being built up and paved over. While the great scientific advances of Thomas Edison may have made the world a brighter place, out of his shadows came a son whose own impressive legacy stopped progress in its tracks.
He had vision, he had, determination. Once he got this in his mind to do it, he was focused forever.
Jamie Wyeth, by the way, tells us he spends most of his time on Monhegan Island in the fall.
That's right. He's never wintered there. He actually jokes around saying trying to heat his home on Lobster Cove is like trying to heat a lobster trap. The wind just whips right through it.
Not to mention the waves crashing over the top, which is entertaining as well. Well, call it Monhegan multitasking. Matt Weber is a lobsterman, brewer, and constable.
I would never put it on. If you see me show up at 11 o'clock at night, you've done something wrong.